The ROG Phone 3 may have had a hidden feature to overclock its display to a 165Hz refresh rate, but this phone right here is the world's first mass-produced smartphone to bring a 165Hz refresh rate out the box, fully stable, and 100% awesome. This is my unboxing and extremely detailed review of Nubia's latest gaming-centric device, the Red Magic 6, in which I'll show off its design, compare it to other gaming smartphones, and test out its 165Hz display, camera capabilities, software, dual DTS:X speakers, 165fps gaming, and finally benchmarks. The Red Magic 6 comes in one color only, and that is Eclipse Black. The 6 Pro comes in Moon Silver. Of course, the 6 and 6 Pro have a difference in RAM and storage. That's pretty much it, aside from the fact that the 6 Pro has an aviation metal in the center of its backplate. The backplate over here also has RGB LED lights, as well as a single red light at the bottom with Red Magic's logo. It looks absolutely phenomenal at the back, and inside of it packs a massive 5050mAh battery, 66W wired charging, 5G NFC, and Wi-Fi 6E. We have Gorilla Glass on the front and a glass back with aluminum frame keeping it all together, and we have aviation grade aluminum on the Red Magic 6 Pro at the center. It is indeed dual SIM, and we also have a USB 3.0 Type-C port and dual DTS:X Ultra speakers, one being at the top using the earpiece. We have a headphone jack, which is thankfully here to stay, and we have triple microphones, one at the top, one at the bottom, and one on the right hand side. On the left we have a volume rocker, the game space switch, and the intake fan vents. On the opposite side we have an exhaust fan vent, a power button, and of course the Pro Shoulder Triggers 3.0. They have a 400Hz touch sampling rate and 8.3ms response time. They are not quite as indented as the Red Magic 5S, but a lot more than that of the ROG phone, and they don't pop up like we've seen on other gaming smartphones around, though I'm not the biggest fan of moving parts anyway. I think that the Red Magic 6 has the perfect balance when it comes to touch triggers, as well as the camera bump being so darn minimal, meaning that when it's on a flat surface, there's pretty much no camera bump affecting the wobble, though it is affected by the curves on the side, which is actually really nice in the hand. The back design is quite subtle compared to other gaming phones around, and while it's a little bit taller than its predecessor, it's a little bit narrower too. It's not too heavy at 220g and 9.7mm thick, which is quite a bit smaller than the ROG Phone 5. The back of the device looks stunning, but what about that front? Well, we are welcome to a 20:9 aspect ratio, 6.8 inch. Yes, it has increased AMOLED display. It is Full HD Plus with 1 billion colors, 630 nits of brightness, 165Hz refresh rate, 500Hz single touch sampling rate, and 360Hz multi-touch sampling rate. Comparing it to the other devices around over here, the color accuracy is pretty much on point with all of them. It is nice, vibrant, and the colors are really deep and rich. And when we compare it when it comes to brightness, yes, it is not the brightest device around, but on the flat surface over here on the table in my studio, it still looks just as bright as the brightest phones around here. And the bezels are pretty minimal, I would say a tad thinner on side by side compared to its predecessor, definitely smaller at the top and the bottom, with pretty much the smallest I've seen on a gaming phone, of course other than the Black Shark 4 Pro, since that's not really a gaming screen. We have 144Hz on the Black Shark ROG phone and Red Magic 5S, 120 on the iQOO, 165 on the Red Magic 6. And yes, I can say jumping from 120 to 165 does feel quite a bit different, but it's not such a big jump between 144 and 165. It is also an adaptive refresh rate between 30Hz and 165Hz to preserve battery life. But if you'd like to keep using that 165Hz refresh rate all the time, you can just jump into developer options and enable it. Of course, we also have all the usual features when it comes to tweaking the display, such as brightness, anti-flicker, as well as display order reverse. So when you get notifications, they pop up at the bottom instead of the top, which is great for one-handed mode. We can change the colors, and we also have dark mode, which is nice and deep, though it doesn't work in third-party apps. It does work with your home screen and notification panel. We also have an always-on display, which can be powered on throughout the day or a time that you prefer to set it at, with loads of different options, and you can even create your own one with a custom picture over there. We also have some different unique ones from Nubia, which look great, though my favorite one is definitely this graffiti art one. Jumping into the phone, you can use the 6th generation under-display fingerprint sensor. It is optical. It is definitely quicker than the Red Magic 5S. S. It is pretty much on par with the iQOO 7. Vivo pretty much known for snappy fingerprint sensors since they kind of invented them. Definitely on par with the ROG phone and a lot quicker than the physical one on the Black Shark 4 Pro. Thankfully, we do have an optical one underneath the display of the Red Magic 6. What we don't have is a 3D facial recognition system, but you pretty much never see that on Android devices. The only one's pretty much Huawei. The 2D facial recognition system is on par with the rest of them in terms of speed, and it can be used as something else, that being taking selfies. We have an 8 megapixel f2.0 selfie snapper via, same as the Red Magic 6 Pro and 5S and 5G.
This is Technic recording a 1080p at 30 FPS video using the brand new Nubia Red Magic 6. Let me know what you guys think of the audio and video when using the selfie cam to record video on the brand new Red Magic 6.
At the back of the device, we have a 64 megapixel Samsung S5K GW3 sensor with an aperture of f1.79. We also have an 8 megapixel ultrawide and 2 megapixel depth sensor. The ultrawide pick surprisingly looks decent over here, even though it's only 8 megapixels. You can only use it in the pro mode. 64 megapixel looks great using AR and 16 bin, looks even better. 2x digital zoom, not too bad. 5x is, I guess, kind of okay for a gaming smartphone. 10x zoom is the max, not really the best. 16 megapixel main bin over here on buzz with portrait looks great, pretty much no edge detection, and we do have a macro mode utilizing the ultra wide sensor, which actually bins it down as well and looks better than most macro sensors I've actually seen, since this phone doesn't actually have one. We do have 8K at 30 frames per second, which is great, looks nice and stunning, though a bit shaky. 4K at 60 FPS, which is awesome. A lot of gaming phones don't actually have 8K, so it's a little bit of a bonus. Nubia were the first to do it with the Red Magic 3, I think. And we do have 1080p and of course 4K at 60 FPS. Nice, smooth, stable, and packed with quality over here. We do have an anti-shake mode over here. When it's on, it does definitely improve the shakiness, drops a bit in quality. We do have Red Magic OS version 4.12, skinned over Android 11. This is as stock as a gaming smartphone can get, guys. It is absolutely awesome how silky smooth it is, not a heavy skin at all, so you can easily jump between things such as multitasking, different apps, and keeping all your apps open in the background, as well as some nice nifty little animated wallpapers. We do have Google rooted into the settings, as well as the Play Store, a Google bar, Google Discover on the left hand side, and of course we have OK Google as well, since it is so darn Google centric. The haptics are superb, since there is 40 shock vibration within the phone for gaming, so of course they're pretty decent. But what about the speakers? Let's go ahead and test them out compared to other gaming phones around. We can adjust the light settings for the back of the phone within the regular settings, as well as enable the fan within the regular settings, but you can also do that in game space, so we're going to flick the switch and jump right on in. This is game space 3.01, and we can flick on the turbo fan right from here. The intake fan is at the bottom when in landscape, and the exhaust is at the top, once again, when in landscape. We also have ICE 6.0 cooling over here with 7 different cooling technologies packed in. And of course, the Red Magic 6 Pro does have that aviation grade aluminum on its back plate. The Snapdragon 888 is at the core of Nubia's Red Magic 6, and it does all things great. We'll get into some games in a second, but what about this Game Space 3.01? It has all the settings that you've come to know and enjoy when it comes to Game Space on Red Magic devices within the actual interface. And then we also have the overlay, which finally includes a frames per second screen overlay, which is fantastic. I've been begging them for this for the past year. We can also change between our hertz on the fly. We have an on-screen reticle as well, pretty much great for shooting things, not really in Genshin Impact, that is. And we can also do macro recording up to 5 minutes. So input a bunch of keys, hit that mapped, and then hit one single key and it plays through what you just did, which could be pretty great in RPG games. There is no charger detected at this point in time, but we can use charge separation when it is plugged in so that the phone consumes power from electricity and not the battery, which preserves heat over time. And we do have a hunting mode so that you can see enemies a little bit clearer. And we do have floating window as well if you want to text friends on the fly. And of course, super performance mode has returned. We also have the pro shoulder triggers at the top right and left corner of the device when in landscape mode, and they can do different functions this time around. You can set it to do one function when you hold it down, and when you lift up it does a second function. You can do that with both triggers as well. You can also allow it to be held down for a macro key, which we created earlier, and you can use them regularly left and right side on map to any button on your screen of your preference. It works pretty well. First game over here is Genshin Impact. The highest possible graphics settings and the max frames per second we can do in the game is 60 fps. It is capped at 60 fps, the game is not the phone, so don't be mistaken about that one. The phone can go all the way up to 165, but this game does not support it. The Red Magic 6 is not really sweating it too much here. A couple of frame dips, but most of the time somewhere between 55 and 60 frames per second, most of the time a little bit on the lower end of that at some times. But remember, it is trying to power a cooling fan as well. When it comes to PUBG Mobile, HDR graphics, extreme fps, and we can turn on the 4D shock over here, the vibration motors, which feels absolutely fantastic. And of course, we can set our little triggers aside over there and pop in our crosshair to make it a little bit easier. It does a great job sitting at pretty much 60 FPS most of the time. 90 FPS is not available yet for the Red Magic 6, though I have no doubt this will be changed by the developers of PUBG Mobile, of course Tencent Games, that is, in the coming future. Call of Duty Mobile now has an update to play at ultra FPS, which is 90 FPS over here, though it is restricted to medium graphics. So we're hitting 90 FPS, as you can see on the minimap, top right-hand corner over there, more than 90 FPS most of the time, which is fantastic in a game as crazy as Call of Duty Mobile. And we can also minimize the game if we'd like by smashing that little slider key into a small mini window while doing other tasks and just pop back into it when you want. But do note, this is limited to just a few games. Bullet Force is another graphics heavy hitting game. Ultra graphics, max FPS most of the time between 130 and 165 FPS, which is fantastic. Dead Trigger 2, another game with no cap when it comes to frames per second. We're sitting at around 150 frames per second most of the time, almost 160 sometimes, and this is a very demanding game, so I'm surprised it handled it this well. Real Racing 3 can't adjust the graphics in FPS, but the game is unlimited and Red Magic always work pretty well with EA, so we're hitting a silky smooth 165Hz refresh rate. But what about benchmarks? Well, the Snapdragon 888 is about to get put to the test, but before we get going, let's check out the battery percentage over here, as well as the degrees in Celsius. We'll compare that at the end of running three benchmarks, that being AnTuTu version 9, the new one that is, and then Geekbench version 5.3.2, and ending off with 3D Mark Wildlife. We are using GameSpace 3.01 to run all three of these benchmarks, as well as Super Performance Mode. At the end of all three benchmark tests, we got a battery drain of 10% with a rate of 31.6 milliamp hours per minute drain. And when it comes to temperature, it only gained 12.8 degrees in Celsius, which is actually phenomenal after running these three benchmarks, thanks to that liquid cooling setup, as well as the active turbo fan. When it comes to AnTuTu version 9, it was definitely better than its predecessor by quite a margin, the Red Magic 5S, pretty much on par with the ROG Phone 5. When it comes to Geekbench, we got a single core score of 1104 and a multi-core of 3331. Its single core is pretty much on par with the rest of them over here, though the multi-core is lacking. When it comes to 3D Mark Wildlife, got a score of 5695 and an average frames per second of 34.1, which in all honesty is only 0.5 FPS worse than the one right at the top, but almost twice the frames of its predecessor. The Red Magic 6 is no doubt one of my favorite gaming smartphones of the year. It has a stunning rear design, which has a mixture of stealthiness and flair for those who enjoy subtle RGB lights. It has a more than capable main camera paired with a surprisingly decent ultra-wide sensor, but I really do hope Team Red can improve these optics going forward, because yes, gamers do take pictures. Flip the device around, tap on that 6th generation fingerprint sensor, and feast your eyes on the massive 6.8 inch AMOLED display, which has minimal bezels wrapping around it. Place your fingers inside that frame and feel the silky smooth 165Hz refresh rate. Flick the switch at the top left of the phone and jump into your gaming kingdom, with weapons like touch triggers, liquid cooling, an active turbofan, and a heart made of Snapdragon's finest 888 chipset, you will be able to power through any game of your choosing. But the Red Magic 6 is not alone in this battle. IQ was always intended to be Vivo's gaming sub-brand, and while the IQ 7 does have gaming features in its software, it lacks things like touch triggers and RGB lights. The Red Magic 5S is still an incredible device, and while upgrading to its newer brother might not be a game changer, it still has a bit of a crazy design and lacks Qualcomm's latest chipset, and the Red Magic 6's faster charging, bigger battery, larger display, and 165Hz refresh rate. The ROG Phone 5 is a monster in its own right, and while it shares many things with the Red Magic 6, it lacked active fan cooling and cost quite a bit more. The Black Shark 4 Pro is very much on par with what Red Magic have to offer, but has no cooling fan, a smaller battery, pop-up triggers, which some may not be too sure on due to them being moving parts, and there's also the fact that it's currently only available in China. That leaves us with the Red Magic 6, a very well-established gaming phone which has been crafted to perfection. It might only be an iterative upgrade if you're coming from its predecessor, but if you're in the market for a new gaming smartphone, I can safely say that the Red Magic 6 is worth a lot more than its unbeatable price tag.